Now, for many Brexiteers, leaving the EU's customs union and having the ability to strike independent trade deals with other nations was of paramount importance. At the top of the list was the United States, with many arguing that Britain would have more of a chance of striking a deal outside the EU. Well, I'm joined now by someone who knows what it's like to be in the room negotiating deals. He's the former US trade official and managing director of the Berkeley Research Group, Harry Broadman. Thank you very much for joining us here on BBC News. First off, we're all talking about the devil being in the detail, but from what you've heard, what do you make of it?
Well, I'm in the same boat as everybody else. I haven't seen the details, but that is usually where the devil is hiding. But at the same time, there also are angels to be discovered in those texts as well. And we'll all know exactly where those lay once we look at the text. But, you know, in every trade deal, people win something, people lose something. And, you know, this will become obvious, I think, in the coming days where those wins and losses are.
I mean, you've been in those rooms, thrashing it all out, trying to meet or to win, as either side, of course, will be trying to do. What's it like in there, normally going through these deals, these negotiations?
Well, they're usually pretty tense, but, you know, some of the tension is as much on the side for whom you are negotiating, because you have to represent to the best of your ability and balancing the national interests what the various stakeholders want. So for instance, in the case of the UK, Mr. Johnson, obviously uppermost in his mind perhaps was the fishermen. But there are other interests that he had to deal with as well, vis-a-vis the EU. And so he was not able to get probably everything that he wanted to give to the fishermen, let's say, you know, versus the truck drivers. And you have to make these kind of trade-offs. So there's tension behind you in terms of who the stakeholders are that you're representing, let alone the tension with the folks you're meeting with on the other side of the table. But they have the same problem as well.
Where do you think, then, the United Kingdom sits right now in terms of striking a deal with the US?
Well, my view is I think that I'm glad that Mr. Johnson was able to do this deal prior to opening serious discussions, frankly, with the US or any other large trading partner, because the US, as any other trading partner would do, would like to see what the relationship would be between the EU and the UK before doing a deal with the UK. So I think with that out of the way, hopefully this is in fact ratified by both sides of the parties, then it's time, if the UK is interested, to approach the US to do a significant free trade agreement, perhaps. Not this mini deal that the current US administration is talking about, but a bona fide free trade agreement. And I think, you know, the US, I think, generally would be receptive to that. It was not the case, certainly, you know, several weeks ago when the Irish border was an issue. But with, I think, that clear, I think there would be, you know, much more interest now in the US.
Let's talk world trade deals. We heard Mr. Barnier talk about the fact that it was unfortunate that this took place at such an uncertain and unstable time. When you've got economic powerhouses like the EU, you've got the US, you've now got Asia, which has just struck the RCEP deal, and of course you've got the United States, was this a good time to go it alone?
Well, that, you know, that decision was taken some time ago, as we all know. And once the UK decided to leave the European Union, there was no turning back in terms of having a deal, because as we know, January 1, things would have been much more messy for the UK. So I don't think, you know, I mean, you can look back and say, well, should they have withdrawn in the first place? I'm not sure that's a fair argument at this point, but having withdrawn, I think the sooner that they were able to do a deal, the better that they will be. And frankly, the world economy will be better off by having them have an agreement, because everybody was apprehensive about, you know, what was going to take place on that side of the Atlantic.
Okay, Harry Broadman, unfortunately, we've run out of time and we have to leave it there.